SARP stands for the Student Airborne Research Program. For airborne science and NASA-related research, there's nothing like the SARP program.
SARP is actually pretty unique in terms of teaching because it's like the mother of all laboratories. So you get to go from the lecture to the airplane to the data collection to their analysis and all the way to presentation in a few short weeks.
The goal of my project was just to determine areas of water stress.
There are three phases of the project. There's the air sampling, the agriculture section, and there's the oceanography section. So there's kind of the air, land, and sea aspect to SARP, and all focusing on interrelated problems and scientific questions environmentally.
So it is real life science. It's not something that happens in a laboratory in a third year chemistry lab. So in that regard, it's wonderful. And then the students do get opportunities to have hands-on work or experiences with various programs that are going to be important in certain fields. And then, of course, the highlight is flying on the NASA DC-8.
What inspired me to apply was the experience to get on a plane and do airborne samples, because we have a plane in my program, and just the opportunity to network and meet other students from around the country.
I'm pursuing a degree in atmospheric science, and unlike a lot of the other internships I applied to this summer, this internship had a field component, which was really appealing. I was involved in the air group. We collected air samples on the DC-8 over the Central Valley, and we even collected samples over the ocean and then brought them back to the lab. We actually got to run some of the analysis machines ourselves, and the idea of like going out and collecting my own research and going out on a plane to do it is really appealing and really exciting.
The thing that most got me interested in the Student Airborne Research Program was the fact that we'd be collecting raw remote sensing data, collecting it directly from the source, and then going to develop an entire research project from that. And with the ocean group, optical oceanography, we specifically focused on the Santa Barbara Channel. There were kelp beds, large area where kelp canopy was actually reaching the surface of the water. And we also had the opportunity to see an algal bloom. We took a field trip and we actually went out into a diving vessel and we collected some reflectance imagery over the kelp beds. It gave us a really grand perspective all the way from being 10,000 feet in the air to on the boat actually within the kelp bed taking radiance measurements. So it was kind of the whole spectrum of doing collecting data, assimilating what you've collected and then making it into a useful scientific tool.
I'm in the almond research, the evapotranspiration land group. So we're looking at the almond and pistachio evapotranspiration in the San Joaquin Valley. And we went into the field, we took samples there of the leaves to get water content, and we did atmospheric calibration as well there. I thought it was really great, you know, the actual gathering of the data on the airplane and then the ground truthing at the site, and you know, we got the whole picture.
I think what a lot of them realize now is that that airborne science does require all sorts of different disciplines.
Everyone kind of came together, and we had engineers, math majors, I'm an earth science major, people that are biology majors. We all came together and had different projects, but they were all relevant to each other.
The interdisciplinary aspect of this program has been really spectacular. I mean, it's wonderful to be able to be not comfortable with a subject and immediately be able to turn to either another student or even a professional and ask those questions and get really good responses, because everyone's just trying to help you learn as much as you possibly can.
I think the connectivity was interesting, this being the second year of the program, that a lot of my students, I put them in email contact with former students who had some pointers here or there, or different expertise, were sharing code and asking questions. You know, I'm sure it's going to be a growing community, sort of. SARP alumni should be, you know, something to look forward to.
So these are relationships that will, in some cases, go on for the rest of their life. Some will be academic relationships. One student will go into modeling somewhere, another one will go into field measurements, and at some point their paths may cross again. I anticipate that some of these students that participated this year and last year will, 5-10 years from now, be working on atmospheric projects, hopefully flying on DC-8.
This is definitely the most like expansive research program I've ever been a part of. I mean, I've done a lot of field work, but this is just another level. It's really just the best thing for getting that hands-on research in science that applies to the world. And it really doesn't matter what discipline you're in. as long as there's something you can take out of it and then connect it to everything else that's going on, you can really sort of see what you can do as a researcher and a scientist by working in this program.